was talking to a friend the other day, and I was telling him how much I love the film look. And then he said, "It's just a trend, bro." And the truth is, it might be right. But can I be honest with you guys? Not that I wasn't planning to be honest, but I still like that look. I like that look right now. I like the nostalgic look. I like the grains. I like the bloom effect and all that stuff. And I'm not just talking about the cinematic look. I'm talking about that sauce that makes it look like you shot it on film. I'm talking about the color, the contrast, or the lack of contrast for certain films, right? And how do you do that in Final Cut Pro? The first tool I'm gonna give you guys is free, but it's more than good enough for most people or most projects. It's been around for a while, but it's still really good, especially because of the value you get for free. It's the BCC Plus Looks. It's from BorisFX, and I'm gonna leave the link in the description, but the features you get for free are just insane. Check this out. You get the 80 drag and drop presets, film stock, diffusion effect, custom effects editor, and mocha tracking. Yes, a free version of the mocha tracking used in high-end movies. Of course, it might not be the same version, but it's still really good. And this alone brings this plugin's value so high, it's insane. Let me show you guys in Final Cut Pro. Let's go to the effects browser. And there it is, BCC Film Style. Let's apply it to our selected clip on the timeline by double-clicking on this effect. And up here in the Video Inspector tab, we have all the parameters that you can tweak in, but also we have help here if you need any help. We have the effects editor, information about the plugin and the license, and what you see in the viewer. Then we have the mocha mask, and it looks like this, but it's a lot, so I'm gonna need to get another video for this one because it's like a whole thing by itself. Let's go back to the effects editor really quickly. This is where you have all that 80 free presets they promised on that website. I'm gonna try the 8mm preset. No, not the black and white one. Yeah, this one. On the right, we have all the parameters we can play around with. We have some color correction tool here, like hue, saturation, and so on and so forth. We also have diffusion, and this is what we need to add that bloom effect from most film look. I usually just play around with the amount. The position and the range will help you control where you want the effect to be at in your clip. Of course, all of this depends on the context of your project, the clip that you shot, or the story that you want to tell. I personally don't like the bloom effect bleed too much in the mid-tones. Then there is this color gradient effect here where you can choose to add a color tone on different side of the clip, from top to bottom or bottom to top, left to right, and right to left. You can play around with it. You can also see the grain here. That's the grain effect, which is another element you see in shots taken on film. I found this effect very aggressive, so I just lower the amount way down somewhere right here, and maybe even reduce the size. All in all, it looks pretty good. The rest is if you want to do minor adjustments after you put all those effects. Now, this window is a little small, so you can of course expand or just close it, and you will see all these adjustments here in the Video Inspector. I usually don't use this as a standalone color grading tool, but just to add that filmic look in my clip. I rarely use the preset, but if I use the preset, I maybe just choose one, pick one, and then adjust here in the Video Inspector instead of in that little window. And all of that for free. You can't tell me that's not value. And we haven't even touched the mocha tracking yet. But if you want more, if you want something more professional, if you want some, you know, something that have more quality in it, the best plugin for the full film experience is still, at least according to me, Dehancer Pro. It's not free, but the quality is definitely there. And as a film emulation plugin, I think this is probably, again, the very best out there. You can use the affiliate link in the description and this code for 10% discount on all of their products. Of course, that will also help this channel. You know all of that already. But like I said before, this plugin mimics the process of shooting and developing film. They just added some recent updates, so let's check it out. Effects browser, film emulation, you know it. Let's apply to the adjustment layer this time. These clips are all log footages, and I was using the Color Finale Pro plugins color space management to transform it to Rec 709. So let's disable that and look at the Dehancer Pro version 7. They've been working on this for a while and they always try to improve the plugin. So let's translate these log footages into Rec 709. Choose camera, vendor. These were shot with the RM Mini, so let's do that. And it already looks like it was 100% shot on film right now. Of course, there are some stuff already enabled here in the plugin, in the parameters here, so we're gonna have to check that. But for the profile, there's a lot of profiles here, but I like the Kodak Vision 3 250D. I like the contrast that this profile gives the clip. Let's do before and after. As you guys can see, yeah, it's before and after. There is the contrast that I want. If you want to play around with Film Developer and compression, don't forget to enable them first so that you can see the changes in the viewer. I also like to play around with the white point and the tonal range to add a little bit of softness in the mid-tone and the highlights. Adjust the impact if it's too much. Same with expand here. But as you can see here, Dehancer also have the print parameters just like what you would do for film. We're gonna add a simple teal and orange effect in the color head section here. Just in the shadow, we're gonna move this slider right here. Let's move this to the right. There you go, just very subtle. After that, you have the grain, halation, and bloom effects. And this is a part of the update they did. You can now choose the type of grain effect you want that will mimic some of the major film stock used for documentary films and movies. Here's the thing, there are actually different types of film look. Filmmakers choose between different types of film stock depending on the look they want to achieve and the project they're working on. You can go with the 35mm like Christopher Nolan. Most of his movies are shot on a 35mm stock. Or you can go with the 16mm for more of a documentary style. You can also go with the Super 8mm for this kind of look right here. It's an even more nostalgic look. With this parameter, you can also choose the amount of grain you want by choosing different ISO versions. ISO 50 will have less grain and 500 will produce the most grain. And I think they still have the best grain I have seen in any plugin. It's not just an overlay. You can see that it's kind of embedded in your clip when you apply it. And I like that. Actually, it's even great because you can still customize all of these features. But let's add halation and bloom for now just to get that look. You can also add film damage if you want to. I don't usually add this unless it's to kind of show a different time in the past. Like, look at the Super 8 film damage. It's really aggressive. I like the look, but not for everything. Film breath and gate weave are still here, but there is this overscan feature here now. And let's enable it just to see what it does. And I'm gonna choose the Super 8mm version. And boom, no need for an extra overlay. It's all done in the same plugin. If you want this look right here, you can also add a vignette to just to complement that look. Use the mask mode to see how this vignette affects the clip. And there you go. The film look. That's it. I hope you guys got some value from this one. The links are in the description. Choose whatever you want, the free version, the BCC Plus look, or the Dehancer Pro if you want more control and more of that organic filmic look. But I'll see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.